Fox News alert, economic sanctions against Iran set to be reimposed at midnight, the first since President Trump decided to pull out of the nuclear agreement back in May. President Trump saying he's willing to meet with top Iranian officials, but Iranian President Hassan Rouhani is pushing back, calling the deal's rejection illegal and saying Iran will not yield to mounting pressure from the Trump administration. Joining me now is former governor of Arkansas and Fox News contributor Mike Huckabee. Governor, thanks for joining us this morning.
Great to be with you. Thanks.
Yeah, good to have you. So these reimposed sanctions set to begin at midnight. What effect, first of all, will these have?
I think they're going to have a dramatic effect because the Iranian economy is so in the toilet. People are struggling. They're suffering. The Iranian government spends all of its money funding terror rather than roads and schools and even programs that help people to live and jobs. So as a result, these sanctions are going to feel pretty harsh within the Iranian economy. And they're needed. They should never have been taken off. The blunder was shipping pallets of cash over to them, taking the sanctions off and giving them a green light to go ahead with their nuclear program. I think it's a terrific thing we're getting them back. I wish that it never happened. It's not just Obama's fault. Let's be clear. Bob Corker, senator from Tennessee, also helped make this happen. It should have been a treaty. It never was. And it's been a disaster from day one to have ever created this situation that really has resulted in the president coming back and saying, we're putting the sanctions back on.
Interesting. And we're waiting on more details from the White House as to exactly what these sanctions will target. Reportedly, they're going to target a range of economic sectors from coal to trade in gold and other precious metals. How do you expect these sanctions to be met by Iranian leaders?
I think they're going to do what they always do. They're going to complain. They're going to whine. They're going to make threats. But increasingly, if they don't have the money to keep funding terror and they have to fund the basic essence of life for the people of their country, that's a good thing. But nothing is going to bring these villains and these thugs to any type of reasonable life, any type of responsible action other than, you know, getting them in a headlock and forcing it. These are not people that you reason with. That's why they've kidnapped Americans, they've killed Americans, they've plotted terror around the world, they fund Hezbollah, they fund Hamas, they fund every kind of mayhem across the planet, and these are not good people. So let's not pretend that, you know, we can sit down and make nice with them, because we can't.
The president tweeted on this over the weekend saying Iran and its economy is going very bad and fast. I will meet or not meet. It doesn't matter. It is up to them. Should the president meet with Iranian leadership?
Not without some conditions. And I think the Secretary of State's made that clear, because these are not people you can sit down and give any type of credibility to. I don't even think it's comparable to the North Korean situation, which was somewhat of a unconditional meeting. But the Iranians have such a long history, Sandra, of violating every agreement they've made. If you look back since 1979, they have not honored not one agreement they've ever made. So for the president to sit down with them gives them a credibility they simply don't deserve.
And I just real quickly want to get in here. The Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo, tweeted on this morning saying, quote, the president and I too have been very clear, I've been very hopeful that we can find a way to move forward. But it's going to require enormous change on the part of the Iranian regime. They've got to behave like a normal country. So that was the statement put out by Pompeo this morning.